All right, we've all seen the video that has made its way around on social media and indeed on mainstream media as well. We're now joined by Member of Parliament of Nandi Hills, Mheshimiwa Alfred Kitera. Thanks for joining us tonight. Let's start by talking about what you were doing at the Weybridge. You claim it was corruption and you were obviously quite worked up in the video. Could you tell us the circumstances that led to you being at the Weybridge?
Yesterday we were in a retreat in Naivasha, and then of course it was graced by His Excellency the President yesterday, and we completed around noon. Then after lunch we had a break to get back to Nairobi, and then when we were in Naivasha we were informed by Kenyans, concerned Kenyans, that they were being mistreated in one of the way bridges, and that is Gilgil. And from then we started engaging them. We tried calling many people to try and really see to it what was happening there. But after many hours, like 3.5 hours to 4 hours, there was no any communication to that effect. So we resorted to go there. And what we found out is that many Kenyans were facing a lot of issues. Others had stayed for 4 days without having clearance with their truck, with issues to do with the excess weight they were loading, and others had many issues. And there were two or three particular cases that we tried confronting the people there.
Right, let's talk about those specific cases, because you mentioned that there were many complaints, but from the video it is clear that it is one particular case and one particular truck. Could you tell us about that truck? Who did it belong to, and what was in it that was so important that got you worked up?
It was reduced into one truck, Yvonne. It was reduced into one truck. And that is the reason why I'm here before you, because I want to give the other side of the story. Because they are giving, it is one line story. But we were complaining over many Kenyans. But the clips that you are getting to the that came to the media is one particular case.
All right, so let's talk about that one particular case that we have seen, because we cannot speak to the others because we don't have that footage. The footage we do have is of one particular truck. Could you give us the details of that truck, who it belonged to, and what were the circumstances surrounding that particular case that we have seen in the clip?
That is what prompted us to go there. It was a truck that was moving a machine, a drilling machine, from to Kabedo. And then that particular machine, we had a lot of interest in it, because one, it was going to finish the work in Kabedo, then it was coming to my constituency to do 3 or 4 boreholes. So when we got there, we realized there were many Kenyans who said, Kitera, it should not be one issue. You are a man of the people, you are a national figure, and we are also complaining. I had about 3 other cases, one from Rwanda, there were 2 from Uganda, and other Kenyans were complaining. In fact, I found out that there was a constituent. My constituent was complaining again that he had his machine, that is farm equipment, and he had stayed for 3 days there. And what the officers were asking from him 35,000 to release his equipment. And he has been staying there for the last 62 or so hours. You can imagine 3 full days.
Okay. That's about All right. Let's get into another issue, because you mentioned the controller of State House not once, not twice, but actually 3 times. He has since come out this afternoon to deny that he ever made any calls to the Weybridge. What is the level of involvement of the State House controller in that particular case? Because you said in the clip that we see that he had been trying to call the Weybridge officials and they had been ignoring his calls. Could you tell us about the involvement of the State House controller in this particular instance?
When we got this issue, we were about 15 members of parliament. And most of us called different individuals. Others called OCBDs, others called State House, all over. But I want to say that most of those individuals came back to us to report that all those individuals that we called had managed to call the Weybridge, and they were denying to communicate or to really tell us what was happening down there.
All right, so did the State House controller call the Weybridge officials?
That is what we were told. You know, there are many things that we
So you cannot be sure that he did in fact make the call or not?
Yeah, I cannot be sure.
Why would he be involved in this case in particular?
No, we were trying to, you know, Yvonne, we were trying to inform those people down there that we have tried engaging him, and many others had tried calling them. There are so many people. I think we can leave that story because the investigation are on now. We will expand. We will expound on that issue, and then we release more evidence to that effect.
All right, just very quickly, because the State House Controller has come out to deny it. What's your take on that?
I've said there are many people who called. If you give us time, we will inform you soon. Like I've informed you, even before me now is my lawyer. This is a case that we have already taken to petition Parliament about.
All right, but you seemed sure in the video, Mwashimi, where you were telling them that they denied or did not pick up the calls of the State House Controller. It didn't sound like you were saying you'd heard that those calls had been made. You were categorical in stating that they had ignored calls from State House.
You know, most of those information that I gave out there, it was after a reaction to corruption levels that is dear to me. When I see serious issues to do with corruption, you become emotional and you can say many things. But I was aware among most of us, about two or three people who are trying to reach State House so that we give a solution, because we are in Jubilee and we are trying to protect the image. So we were trying to see whether we can engage others to really give a solution so that Kenyans don't continue saying that we are not concerned about the challenges, the mistreatment that they are facing.
So you were not misusing the President's name or that of the State House Controller?
I was not. I was trying to inform them that we have tried calling each and every individual, be it in national government, be it in the county government of Nakuru, with the police side, everyone. We even tried calling some officials from KENHA, Kenya National Highways Authority. And we were trying to report this particular case. And we had many cases then when we got to the place of the that incident. So most of those stories that we said, it was out of a reaction. You know, corruption, you cannot face it while smiling. It's not a wedding ceremony or a birthday party to really smile about it. And this is some of the issues that is making Kenyans to have teachers to have a low pay. This is one of the issues that is making police officers to be paid low. That's okay. Why they take bribes. So it
All
is
right.
so dear to us.
Okay.
It becomes very emotional when you face
it. So you believe that State House is important in this fight. However, they have come out tonight and have distanced themselves from you. We have seen the statement from Manoah Esipisu. We've also seen the statement from the State House Comptroller himself. What's your take then, if they seem to be distancing themselves from this so-called fight against corruption at the Weybridge?
They are not distancing themselves because I'm not aware of that. But let me say what I know, because it is important for me to report what I know already. One is that we tried reaching many individuals. Number two is that when we got there, we realized we are not fighting for one Kenyan. There were so many other Kenyans who had issues with mistreatment at the Weybridge. Some were claiming that they passed a Weybridge in Mariakani.
Okay.
Passed
okay.
another Weybridge in Mlolongo.
Mlolongo. Uh-huh.
Then by that time they were getting to Gilgit. Their weight, it was alleged to have increased by 2 tons. So we were wondering, if it is in Mariakani, it is weighing less. It gets
right.
to Mlolongo, it
so
is weighing less.
Allow
when
me to
it
get
gets
back
to Gilgit,
to,
uh-huh. it is overloaded by 2 tons. That's over 2,000 kilos, which is a serious matter.
Okay, all right. So these are some of the issues that you are talking about, and we'll get to some of those statements that came out in just a moment. If
no
you can
problem.
Just hang on, we will get to that statement shortly.
Thank you.